Next problem is fx equals to x cube minus 9x square plus 24x plus c equals to 0 has three roots alpha, beta, gamma. If alpha, beta, gamma are real and distinct such that greatest integer of alpha plus greatest integer of beta plus greatest integer of gamma equals to 8, then the complete set of the values of c where box represents the GIF. Solution. So given is fx equals to x power 3 minus 9x square plus 24x plus c equal to 0 has three distinct real roots. So fx equals to 0 has three distinct roots, so we should get lighter graph. That means this is local maxima and this is local minima. So local maxima into local minima is less than 0, so we can say that fx has three distinct roots. So for finding local maxima and local minima, we'll differentiate fx. So f dash x will get as 3x square minus 18x plus 24. So f dash x equals to 0. So if I equate 3x square minus 18x plus 24 equal to 0. If I take 3 common, x square minus 6x plus 8 equal to 0. So from here we'll get 3 times of x minus 2 into x minus 4 equal to 0. So from here we can say 2 and 4 decide plus minus plus. So at 2 we'll get local maxima, at 4 we'll get local minima. So we can say f of 2 into f of 4 must be less than 0. Find out f of 2. So if I put 2 here, we'll get 8 minus 9 into 4 plus 24 into 2 plus c into, if I put 4 here, we'll get 4 cube minus 9 into 4 square plus 24 into 4 plus c is less than 0. So if I simplify this one, we'll get c plus 20. And similarly, if I simplify this one, we'll get c plus 16, should be less than 0. So this will get us minus 20 minus 16 plus minus plus. So we want this side should be negative, so we'll take negative portion. So we can say c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. So we can say fx equals to 0 has three distinct real roots if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. X is given greatest integer of alpha plus greatest integer of beta plus greatest integer of gamma equal to 8, where alpha, beta, gamma are roots of fx. So if I put f of 0, so f of 0 is what? C. And we know c is less than 0, so we can say f of 0 is what? Less than 0. Similarly, if I check f of 1, so f of 1 is what? 1 minus 9 plus 24 plus c. So this will get as what? 16 plus c. And we know c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. So we can say 16 plus c always less than 0. If I put 2 here, so f of 2 equals to 2 cube minus 9 into 2 square plus 24 into 2 plus c equal to, this will get as what? 20 plus c. So 20 plus c, we can say if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16, so we can say 20 plus c is what? Greater than 0. So we can say f of 1 into f of 2 is always less than 0. So we can say 1 root, suppose alpha, lies between 1 and 2. So greatest integer of alpha will be 1. You will find out f of 3. So if I put 3 here, we'll get 3 cube minus 9 into 3 square plus 24 into 3 plus c. So this will get as 18. So we'll get 18 plus c, where c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. From here we can say f of 3 is less than 0 if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 18, or f of 3 is greater than 0 if c belongs to minus 18 to minus 16. we know f of 2 is greater than 0. So from here we can say f of 2 into f of 3 is less than 0 if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 18. Another case, f of 2 is also positive and f of 3 is also positive. So in this case, f of 2 into f of 3 is greater than 0 if c belongs to minus 18 to minus 16. So in this case, we can say that other root, that is beta, lies between 2 and 3. So we can say greatest integer of beta will be 2. In this case, we will not get anything. So we will find out f of 4. So if I put 4 here, we will get 4 cube minus 9 into 4 square plus 24 into 4 plus c. So we will get as 16 plus c. So we know c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. So we can say f of 4 is less than 0. And we know f of 3 is less than 0 if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 18. So we can say f of 3 into f of 4 is greater than 0 if c belongs to minus 20 to minus 18. And f of 3 into f of 4 is less than 0 if c belongs to minus 18 to minus 16. So in this case, we can say other root lies between 3 and 4. So we can say greatest integer of beta will be 3. F of 5. So if I put 5 here, so 5 cube minus 9 into 5 square plus 24 into 5 plus c. Now if you simplify this one, we'll get f of 5 equals to 20 plus c, where c belongs to minus 20 to minus 16. So f of 5 we will get as greater than 0. So f of 4 we know less than 0 and f of 5 is greater than 0. So we can say f of 4 into f of 5 is less than 0. So we can say third root lies between 4 and 5. So we can say greatest integer of gamma is 4. Greatest integer of alpha plus greatest integer of beta plus greatest integer of gamma equal to 8. We know greatest integer of alpha is 1 and greatest integer of gamma is 4. So if I put the value, we will get greatest integer of beta equal to 8 minus 1 minus 4, that is 3. From here we can say greatest integer of beta should be 3. That will come in this case. So this case is possible if c belongs to minus 18 to minus 16. So answer will be c belongs to minus 18 to minus 16. In other case, if greatest integer of beta is 2, so sum will get 1 plus 2 plus 4, that is 7. We want sum should be 8. So this is your answer. Next problem is, let ABC be distinct non-zero real numbers satisfying AQ plus PQ plus 6ABC equals to 8CQ. Then which of the following can be correct, where omega equals to e power 2π/3 and iota equals to root or minus 1. First option is ACB are in AP. Second option is ACB are in HP. Third option is A plus B omega minus 2C omega square equal to 0. And fourth option is A plus B omega square minus 2C omega equal to 0. Now solution. Given is A cube plus B cube plus 6ABC equal to 8C cube. This we can add A cube plus B cube minus 8C cube plus 6ABC equal to 0. This we can add A cube plus B cube plus minus 2C whole cube minus 3 times of A into B into minus 2C equal to 0. X cube plus Y cube plus Z cube minus 3XYZ we can write as X plus Y plus Z into X square plus Y square plus Z square minus XY minus YZ minus ZX. This equation we can write as X plus Y omega plus Z omega square into X plus Y omega square plus Z omega. If I use this formula, we can write this expression A cube plus B cube plus minus 2C whole cube minus 3 times of A into B into minus 2C equal to A plus B minus 2c into a plus b omega minus 2c omega square into a plus b omega square minus 2c omega equal to 0. So from here we will get a plus b minus 2c equal to 0, or a plus b omega minus 2c omega square equal to 0, or a plus b omega square minus 2c omega equal to 0. So a plus b minus 2c equals to 0. So 2c equals to a plus b. So we can say ACB are in AP. So first option is correct and second option is wrong. Next is a plus b omega minus 2c omega square equals to 0. That means C option is also correct. And third is a plus b omega square minus 2c omega equal to 0. So D option also correct. So A, C, D are correct.